Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ, our Passover Lamb, has been sacrificed for us. Let us therefore rejoice by putting away all malice and evil and confessing our sins with a sincere and true heart. Father eternal, giver of light and grace, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in what we have thought, in what we have said and done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We have wounded your love and marred your image in us. We are sorry and ashamed and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and lead us out from darkness to walk as children of light. Amen. Almighty God, forgives all who truly repent. Have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Risen Christ, your wounds declared your love for the world and the wonder of your risen life. Give us compassion and courage to risk ourselves for those we serve, to the glory of God the Father. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After there had been much debate, Peter stood up and said to the apostles and elders, "My brothers, you know that in the early days God made a choice among you, that I should be the one through whom the Gentiles will hear the message of the good news and become believers. And God, who knows the human heart, testified to them by giving them the Holy Spirit, just as he did to us. And in cleansing their hearts by faith, he has made no distinction between them and us. Now therefore, why are you putting God to the test by placing on the neck of the disciples a yoke that neither our ancestors nor we have been able to bear? On the contrary, we believe that we will be saved through the grace of the Lord Jesus, just as they will." The whole assembly kept silent and listened to Barnabas and Paul as they told of all the signs and wonders that God had done through them among the Gentiles. After they finished speaking, James replied, "My brothers, listen to me. Simeon has related how God first put favourably on the Gentiles to take from among them a people for his name. This agrees with the words of the prophet, as it is written, 'After this I will return, and I will rebuild the dwelling of David which is fallen. From its ruins I will rebuild it, and I will set it up, so that all other people may seek the Lord, even the Gentiles over whom my name hath been called. Thus says the Lord, who has been making these things known from long ago. Therefore I have reached the decision that we should not trouble those Gentiles who are turning to God, but we should write to them to abstain from only things polluted by idols, and from fornication, and from whatever has been strangled and from blood. For in every city for generations past, Moses has had those who proclaim him, for he has been read aloud every Sabbath in the synagogues." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Response to a psalm is, "Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Sing to the Lord and bless his name. Tell out his salvation from deed to deed. Sing to the Lord a new song. Declare his glory among nations and his wonders among all peoples. Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord honor and strength. Sing to the Lord a new song. Ascribe to the Lord the honor due to his name. Bring offerings and come into his courts. O worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth tremble before him. Sing to the Lord a new song. Tell it out among the nations that the Lord is King. He has made the world so firm that it cannot be moved. He will judge the peoples with equity. Sing to the Lord a new song. Now have our gospel reading. Please stand as we come. Thank you. Alleluia, alleluia. Jesus said, all who see the Son and believe in him may have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, as the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you, so that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be complete. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May the words of my lips and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer.
Amen.
Throughout history, the Christian Church has held councils, bringing together church leaders to discuss difficult issues or major problems. And in our first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, we find the first of such councils convened by the apostles to discuss the big issue of their day. The early church had begun as a group of Jews who followed Jesus' teaching, heeded his call to mission, bringing God's love and light to all people, not just the Jews, but to the Gentiles also. It was then almost inevitable that as these two groups with different traditions and understandings come to conflict, the big problem was, how can these two groups be brought together to form one united, harmonious people? It was to rise above the adherence to this tradition or that tradition, to these rules or those. Unity was to come through commitment to following Christ and serving him in ministry and in mission. We are saved not because we deserve to be, but simply through God's love and mercy. And our mission together is to proclaim that love and mercy to those around us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us pray. Give to the Church, chosen and called to service, the love for all which reveals the love of God. As we have received grace, may we be channels of his peace, now and always. Lord, in your mercy, grant to those who hold authority the love which is stronger than the love of power. May they know that true authority is from above, and is fulfilled not in command, but in service. Grant that love shall drive out hatred between people and nations, that the whole world may be at peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Christ has called us to be his friends. Increase in us the gift of friendship towards all who come close to us in our daily lives. By our love for one another, may we show that we have heard his voice and answered his call. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all who are suffering in body, mind, or spirit. We continue to hold in our prayers John Ellison, Jessica McCaskill, Carrie Waggett, Doreen Moyig, Andrew Garbuck, Mrs. Hewitt, Sid Harrison, Pat Middleton, Dorothy Macbeth, Stella Matthews, Michael Hughes, Chris Haynes, Tom McKenzie, Julie, John Pike, Anne Taylor, Rod Taylor, Carol Woodfield, Christine, Beatrice Yorston, Wynne Alderslade, Grant and Sheena, Gillian, Mavis, Harriet Fraser, Grant Macbeth, Susan Fisher, Ruth Banks, Jane Shepherd, Marjorie Carruthers, Brian Henderson, Anne Henderson, Brenda Prophet, Peter and his family, Stan, Gary, Jim, Joan Thorburn, Ashton, Mary, Margaret Lambert, and any others who are in our hearts and minds today.
Dorothy Long.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who have died, that their joy may be complete, and that in due time we too may come to that eternal joy. We pray especially for the repose of the soul of Sue Burnell, Karen Atherton, Margaret Hoy, Pat Henshaw, and Josh. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then they were glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. And the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Thank you.
have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will, and won for you a holy people. And now we give you thanks, because in his victory over the grave, a new age has dawned. The long reign of sin is ended, a broken world is being renewed, and humanity is once again made whole. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Granted by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. From the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Praise to you, Lord Jesus. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Let let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. Let us pray. Lord God, our Father, through our Saviour Jesus Christ, you have assured your children of eternal life, and in baptism have made us one with him. Deliver us from the death of sin, and raise us to new life in your love, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live your work to your praise and glory. Amen. God the Father, by whose glory Christ was raised from the dead, strengthen you to walk with him in his risen life. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.